Well, the moment has passed. Back to work!
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here with How a Spy Thinks number 90. And today, I want to talk about the things that new players do that are just wrong. And some of it is from playing other games, and you've gotten used to another first-person shooter, and you've come into TF2, even though TF2 itself is an old game. But some of the things that are happening in the other games just are not true in Team Fortress. Like, for example, I've seen people come on in as new snipers, and they will go to a window and try to snipe people through windows. But of course, anyone who's been in TF2 knows you cannot shoot through objects. You cannot even shoot through, you know, chicken fence looking stuff. Even though in our minds, you know, the bullet would go through the fence, it just doesn't happen. So it's kind of cute when you see a new player doing that. You know they're new to the game. You never know if a player's new just because they're wearing a gibbous or they're wearing pyrovision goggles. But sometimes they are. I think the number one obvious thing of a new player is they have no understanding of the map, the route of the map, where they need to be, why they need to be there. And that's something you cannot learn overnight. You can learn if you watch videos, if you watch some playthroughs, if you see how other people are doing it, but honestly, you could walk into Twofort and you don't know the way from the battlements to the basement. That stuff has to be learned over time. New players, they'll be walking out of spawn, they don't know where to go, and even though there's big arrows pointing the way and tracks indicating the roll of the payload, they don't know where to go. Points are labeled A, B, and C. Well, they've never even seen a second point, so how do they know where B point is? They're never going to find it. Next comes the understanding of their own weapons and the weapons that the enemy are using on them. I mean, how are you meant to kill an enemy with the weapon you've got? Sure. Point at them, click button. Okay, that bit's obvious, but you know, each weapon is different. You're not going to use a soldier's rocket launcher the same way you're going to use a spy's pistol. I think that's where some of the angst against spies comes from early on from players, because they're just going along, bam, they're dead. They didn't see it, they had no way to avoid it. They don't understand how spy works, how the knife works, so they're not even looking for it. And then later on, as you become more experienced, you're more ticked off at the spy because, well, they got you even though you were trying to be observant. Okay, after understanding your own weapons and the enemy weapons, next in line is understanding your job on the team, your role, how best to help your team as a class you pick. Now, some people don't even care for this. Some people are just out to have fun. They're not worried about their role on the team. They're not worried about the objective. They couldn't care less. But the objective is important. The objective is more important than somebody getting a dominate on you or you dominating an enemy. I've given my life so many times to meet an objective that I've lost count. People have dominated me because I've been going after a particular target and pretty much putting them on ignore more times than I can count. Getting dominated or getting a revenge on someone is not significant, even though it gives you feel goods. I mean, you dominated someone, great, you're doing great. You got revenge on someone, excellent, I finally killed that person who's been killing me. That's great, okay. But it's not important to the game. What's more important to the game is that clock. That clock determines when the game ends. Who wins, who loses. If you're not paying attention to the clock, and new players do not, you could be setting yourself up for more losses than wins. A good example of this is, as a spy, as it starts getting down into the last minute, my attention definitely turns to making sure that the teleporter is down. If I can get the teleporter down in the last minute of the game, that's fantastic, because that's going to stem the tide of enemies that are going to be able to rush the payload or rush the objective of the map in the last minute of the game. The engineer is never going to get that teleporter up. Even if he focuses on getting the teleporter up in the last minute, he's only going to get it to level 1, maybe level 2 if he commits his whole effort into doing it. Some new players do try and get ahead of the curve, and they're like, okay, well, this is a map where the game ends if the enemy team caps a payload at the final point. So me, as an engineer, I'm going to go and make sure I get a sentry gun that is guarding that final point. But they should have been setting up a defense at every objective along the way. Every now and then, you're going to come up against a situation where there is something that your class could do, or if you took a different loadout, you might be able to do it better. But do understand sometimes that there's stuff that your class cannot do. Like for example here, I could have flung myself at the sentry nest as a spy over and over and over again, and maybe one time gotten lucky. But instead I changed to a medic, one uber, walked the heavy in, completely destroyed the place. That sentry gun was holding up our team for ages, and I'm like, well, why don't we have an uber take it out? Well, since nobody was willing to do that, I switched to medic, built up an uber, we walked in, took the place down, and went on with life. So a new player finally understands the roles, they finally understand some of the loadouts, and they get in their head for some reason, and most new players do this, that heavy is a god. I mean, look at how much health a heavy has. The heavy often gets pocketed by a medic. The heavy's got a huge machine gun that can mow down enemies. But it's not the case, especially as a spy main, and if anyone has been on this channel, you know how fragile a heavy can be. Unless a demo knight turns them around. I mean, there is various and sundry ways to kill a heavy. Of course, I'm going to prefer the old knife in the back, but you know, that's often not the only way. I mean, their big old slow head is often a target for snipers. They are slow and lumbering, so they often need teleporters or faster ways to get back to the front line after being killed. If a spy is harassing your heavy, maybe you need a pyro to help take it out. But you've got to also understand that just because you've got a pyro on your team doesn't mean that the spy is going to die. I mean, the pyro class itself is a good counter to the spy, but it's not an absolute. Just because you have some pyros, even if the pyros are trying to stay observant, it is everyone's job to look out for spy. Keep your eyes open. Check your kill feed. Spies will show up there often. Look for irregularities in the disguises. Players out of position where they shouldn't be. Come on, you've understood the map now. You understand the routes now. You understand the role of your characters. If you see someone out of place, you can call it out. You can check it. You can make sure it's not a spy. Check your back often, or spy will find your back open. So often a new player will switch over to heavy. He's a fairly easy character to understand the mechanics of, but just like poker, the difference between a good poker player and a bad poker player becomes abundantly clear. You know, it's the same game, simple rules, you get dealt a hand, you can give up some cards, you've got to make a better hand than your opponent. But a good poker player knows of the extra gambits, the tells, the bluffing that goes on in the game. That's the next level stuff that you need to get into. And it's the same with Team Fortress. I mean, I'll often mislead a target, or I'll do things that I know they're looking for, and then they don't suspect it. So for example, I just stabbed the heavy there. I've been getting a few stabs on him. He's become very spy aware. So let's get him at the next step. Let's see, if I decloak up here, he shouldn't see me once he gets to the stairs. People rarely look up. Looks like he's got a sniper friend with him, he's checking his back. He called for spy, he's looking. But nope, at the point where he wants to actually be looking at my team, that's when I strike. New players going heavy will sometimes blame a medic as being the reason they died, or the reason we're dying is because we do not have a medic. And while it is somewhat true, it is not totally correct. I mean, if your team has no medic, the ability for you to switch to a medic is the same as everyone else's ability to switch to a medic, and you could go medic instead of going AFK, apologies spy. But I need the health, because I've got the kunai. Always want to be topped up before I go on in against that heavy. No, he changed. Oh, someone's on my right, someone's on my left. Get out of here. Do a big circle. Go back. And lastly, I see this a lot because I am spy, and when you stab someone and then go into your cloak, it can show on their death cam that you are invisible. So a new player will often call out a spy or a really good sniper as cheating. The accusations abound amongst new players because they barely understand the game themselves. They're still trying to get a grip on what is happening around them. So when somebody gets shot by a sniper, or somebody gets stabbed by a spy, it's an instant death from full health when they think they're in a good position, and they just don't know. They do not know what they don't know. So thanks for watching, I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Let me know in the chat what you have seen new players doing, because I think it's cute and fun. Hey, while you do leave me a comment, be sure and like and subscribe, it does help a lot. If you did like this video, I think you might enjoy other videos that I have on Spy, or maybe the funny ones where I parody myself with Spy Thonks.